Hey everybody, SciStarCraft here, and I need to adjust the sound real fast. I hope the music's not too loud. I haven't done that in a while. I remember when every time I started a commentary, I used to immediately... Cat, shut up, man! Get out of here! Isaac! I used to always go into the sound and have to change everything around and make sure everything was fixed. And so that's the first time I've had to do that in a while. So we have I don't even know what I'm saying. I should just let you guys watch. Actually, no, I tried that once. Remember when I didn't do any casting, I just did spectating? And you guys didn't like that very much. So we have 6-2 representing Team Insanity as the Green Terran in the top right. And we have Hashe, which looks like Hashe, but he couldn't use the name Hashe, H-A-S-H, because Blizzard wouldn't allow it, so we added an E at the end. But capitalizing the H makes me believe it's pronounced Hashe, but it's actually pronounced Hashe, so I don't like the capitalization of the H. That's already a misstep by Hashe. Hashe, I'll call him Hashe. But he's in the bottom left representing Team Vile as the Pink Terran. Vile Gaming, that is. That's my team. We're kind of just getting started. We're working on sponsors, working on the website, all that good stuff. But this is a clan war between Vile and Insanity, and this is game number 7. Crixus took out 3 of our players, Hashe took out 4 of their players. This is game number 7. No, this is game number 8. Game number 8. So if Hashe wins this, we win the clan war. If 6-2 wins it, or Sixto, I'll be up next, and I'll have to finish him off. It would be an ace match. Ace match is where whichever team wins the war, 4-4. So if Hashe does end up losing this game, I will be in for the ace match, and you guys will finally get to see some Psy. And if I'm not, for some strange reason, if I'm not in the ace match, and I just did all these matches without me being in it, I do have tons of awesome replays. I played in several tournaments lately, got into the semis in one, got into the finals in one of them, actually won $5. So I have awesome replays for you guys against like some 3,100, 3,200 people. And it's going to be sick, man. It's just going to be sick. So I look forward to that, and also look forward to some nude photos of mine being leaked on the internet, and me and Isaac, maybe some bestiality, I don't know, we'll see. Play your cards right, you might see some Hashe trying to sneak a SCV in. Sixto not really bothering to micro that first Marine just because the second Marine was going to clean up. And we're seeing 2 very fast gas from Sixto, so we might see some fast tech from him. Hashe, meanwhile, just choosing to get that one gas. He is pumping out a Reaper, going to be doing some scouting. And this is what I like about Hashe. He doesn't do anything super, super tricky. Like, he's kind of like a Zerg Terran. He plays very reactionary. He wants to know what his opponent is doing. He'll expand fast and react to what his opponent is doing. And that's why he's getting that Reaper, because, you know, if you have an expansion, you can usually fend off a very standard play from your opponent, you know, with bunkers and quicker reinforcement and stuff like that. But if you're expanding and your opponent does something unorthodox, like Banshees, or I don't know what Terran does, Banshees, really fast stim, I have no idea, then you're going to have to see it if you want to defend it if you are fast expanding. So that's why we're seeing the Reaper from Hashe. Reaper's pretty solid in any matchup, really, especially ZBT, TVZ. Just get one Reaper against a Zerg as a Terran, man. It is so darn annoying. Just, you can't scout with your links until you get speed. You can pick off some drones. You can be really annoying against the Queen. Pick off creep tumors if they fast expand and lay down creep tumors fast. Oh, he might actually kill his mule. And that is why Reapers are so darn good. Just little things like that just add up like huge. That mule had a lot of time left. So he probably lost 210, 240 minerals just by Hashe getting that one Reaper. Looks like he actually killed 2 units. He might have killed an SCV as well. But no Banshees as of yet. He is getting a tank, and he's also getting a starport. So we might see the tank come out and then swap and get a Banshee, or we might just see a medevac and some kind of tank marine play with a dropship. Maybe some dropping, maybe just some healing with the medevac. Who knows? Hashe, meanwhile, his expansion is up, and he's getting an Overlook Command, 3 racks, 1 factory. So, so standard. So solid, man, just all around. And there's that tech bat, so we will see a Banshee to accompany these tanks and Marines. And might see an early push as well. That's what it leads me to believe. I mean, if you're not expanding, you would expect that that player is going to push, though. I'm not a genius. It's just common sense. Oh, it's going to be a Raven. That's kind of weird. What would a Raven do? I'm trying to think what a Raven would do TBT. I mean, in kind of the mid-game, you see Ravens being used against Vikings when you're trying to take air control. for a point defense drone, but this early, it's kind of weird. Maybe he's just saving it for energy. It works against Marauders. And let's check out the Harvester count. Hash down by one. That's fine. He's going to be expanding. He'll be pumping out of two command centers, and he's going to have double the mules. And also some scan as well. 6-2. Nice little patrol going on there. Swapping on. So he got his one Raven. He's going to swap onto here. Maybe get some Medivacs and Vikings. I don't know. And maybe get some Marauders as well. Going heavy on the tanks. He does have Siege mode. Still pumping out the SCVs. Is he expanding? Yeah, now he's preparing his expansion. So if we don't see any kind of early pressure from 6-2, he's going to be behind. I don't really know what he's doing right now. I mean, if you're going to not expand earlier than you could, you definitely need to put on some kind of pressure, which we're not seeing as of yet. Hash with a nice little infantry force. A couple Vikings coming out. Gonna have air dominance here. Hash barely getting a starport, just now getting a... Aw, that's so sweet. Thank you, SCV host. I'm gonna have to ignore you and put you on busy, though. Sorry. Owned. Here we go. Here's the pressure. So he has enough for 1 point defense drone, or maybe two auto turrets, whichever he chooses. He's gonna want to land these Vikings when he does engage, because he's gonna want to do damage with this, and if two Vikings are just flying in the air not doing anything, that's kind of troublesome. Kind of... That grinds my gears, man. So 6-2, moving out now. Hash, he's gonna go for the flank. That's very cool. That scan does not catch Hash's units at the top, so he's only got 5 infantry. He does have stim, no combat shield, 1 SCV coming out, spotting this army, and he's gonna wait for the Marines to engage, maybe in the even the Vikings, and then come in behind with 3 Marauders and these 7 Marines. And he's even got the tower, made sure to have the tower as well. And this is actually gonna be really effective. 6-2 is taking this a bit too slow. Hash is reinforcing with a lot of infantry, and I have a feeling Hash is gonna clean up here. Well, he's got a third tank. Oh, that's not the best timing by Hash. He could have come from the back a little sooner, but it looks like he will do the job. Wow, this is actually really close. Yeah, it looks like those Marauders just pulverized those tanks. Those 3 tanks, man. Marauders kill tanks in just 9 shots. That's incredible. So just these 3 Marauders, pew, pew, pew. Killing those tanks, dropping them. Now Hash has taken the lead. He's got his expansion down already. Pumping SCVs out of both command centers. If we look at the army tab, he's actually a little bit behind in the army tab, just because infantry don't cost much. And he's still working off that expansion, but he is ahead in the supply, 38 to 31 now. So, actually, you know, despite 6-2 losing that push and Hash expanding early, he's not doing too bad. 6-2 isn't too far behind. A little bit behind, I would say that. He's down in the harvester count. I feel like Hash, his army is more mobile. 6-2 can't really plan on pushing anytime soon, especially with the tank, a worthless Viking, a Raven with no energy, just a couple Marines. He does have stim. That's kind of cool. Hash busting down the wall, already getting a third base. He is such a Zerg player at heart, man. I wonder if he ever played Zerg, because that is, he plays so much like a Zerg. Like, you come at me, I'll kill you, man. You come at me again, I'll kill you. I'm not going to attack you, I'm going to expand again. Just wait for the enemy and stuff like that. It's really cool. Not really seeing too many production buildings from 6-2. A lot more coming from Hash. 4, actually, he's just got one more racks than 6-2. 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2 from Hash. BM. BM like crazy. Where are these tanks going? Oh, they're going to shoot at this Marine. Whoa, that's kind of weird. Oh, no, that poor Marine. 6-2 did have control of that tower. Hash still up by 4 on the SCV count, so they're steadily gaining the same number of SCVs. I don't know if this lack of gas is intentional or not. He's only got one on each geyser. I think he just finished... Oh, sorry about this. I missed a drop. Not much happened. It looks like he picked off the supply depot, a couple SCVs. If we look at the harvester count, 37 to 45, so it looks like he killed about 4 or 5 SCVs. Vikings now coming in. Are the Vikings going to snipe this? Vikings are 0.25 faster than a medevac. Since the latest nerf, he's dropping down some Marines as a decoy, but it's not going to be enough. He should have tried to just maybe drop down here, get the units away however he could. Really wishful thinking, though. There's not really much he could have done there. Maybe snipe a couple units, snipe a tank, something like that. He did try to get away. Don't blame him. It's very hard to make that kind of judgment call in that sort of situation. So A little unfortunate. He did pick off some SCVs, though, so not too one-sided there. And 6-2 is actually not producing anything at all right now, and that's what happens. That's what happens when you supply cap yourself. Hashe must have picked off a lot of supply depots here, so maybe he was focusing down supply depots at the top with the intention of supply blocking 6-2. Holy shit, he is down 78 to 115. Hashe has taken a huge lead. He's now got the high yield planetary fortress coming, and this is where mules really shine. I mean, they shine before, but like this is like shining the movie Shining. That's how much they shine. They shine so much they don't actually shine, glisten. They shine like the movie. Alrighty. So that first push was really the only pressure Hashe has been under. I mean, that drop supply locked him for a while. He couldn't get a huge army. And now Hashe is looking great. He's up 40, 39 on supply. 41, actually. Not anymore. And really, he just has to fend off this next attack. If we look at the army, wow, Hashe is just overwhelming him with army count. The only thing 6-2 has going for him is tanks. If he positions the tanks nicely, if Hashe engages, you know, at a bad angle or something like that, 6-2 can clean up this army. Oh, is Hashe going to see this? He is dropping in the main and the expansion at the same time, but he has to kill this attack. Otherwise, this attack could do a lot of damage to his main. I'm going to be focusing on this right now. Oh, Hashe coming from behind with some more units. Are these Marauders going to do the job? Yeah, they do the job. Wow, that's a lot of damage. The main being dropped, the expansion being dropped. So that extra supply is what allowed Hashe to do those drops and survive down here. Vikings dropping 51 to 110. This is an all-in from 6-2. He transferred his SCVs after that drop, just killed everything. 6-2, LOLing and GGing. LOL, I suppose. And that was some nice play from Hashe. I mean, I don't know if he timed those drops on purpose to go in as 6-2 was moving out. Even if he did or didn't, it didn't really matter just because he had out-macroed him so hard at that point. That first attack, I think it came way too late from 6-2. Hashe was able to use that expansion to get enough money, get an infantry force, a nice little flank, and take him down. So that is it, you guys. Team Vile has taken down Team Insanity. You know what that means? It means there is no Psy. I actually did not get to play in this clan war. I know you guys are just like waiting for me to like be up and ace everyone, but I thought Hashe played so good. 3 Zerg players, 1 Toss, 1 Terran. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I've got some sweet replays coming up next week for you. And that's it. And I love you. And I want to have babies with you. Goodbye.